Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the newly redesigned Valiant Wrestling Alliance. I'm going to let these entrances play out real quick before I get back into commentary. So, now as the anti-hero Marcus Williams finishes up here, now we'll introduce our television champion, Elijah Riley.
The day that passes by, the pain is not a massive side. It's breaking me down to the ground. It's like I crash and died. It's hard to leave your past behind, especially when you're last in line. And half the time it acts like vines and wraps inside my fragile mind. Not an in-play view, it seems the same old shit I choose between. Taking who I used to be and keeping it subhumanine. Close to dead and losing me, you took a chance and you believe. So did I let you lead and grab the light you threw to me. And through it all, you said.
And I am back now. This is the Television Championship Open Challenge, as you can see, covered by a black square. Thank you, 2K. The Television Championship, the every week must be defended. If you're new to the show, or I mean, if you bother to know, it must be defended every week. Elijah Riley, the current champion, after winning it back in that little mini show, I guess you can say, after he lost it to Durag Jones a couple months back. But now his first opponent of the new season, I guess you could say, Marcus Williams, making his debut. The ref calling for the bell now. Elijah Riley, hopefully, I mean, if he loses this on the very first episode, I don't know what this is going to do for his confidence level. But Marcus already having a hammerlock. Oh no, wait. Maybe that's a hammerlock. Not too familiar on the wrestling terminology right there. Excuse me, I'm still getting over being sick. So be very patient with me. Now, oh, Marcus with an elbow to the arm. Went for a knee but missed. Now going back into a lockup. A lot of wrestling being shown here, which we love here at Valley Wrestling Alliance. But ref trying to pull them apart now. Oh, and now a clothesline into the corner. Now just a knee to the face. Mr. Showtime definitely being a little bit aggressive here. Oh wait, went for a kick but got caught. Tripping it up, now going for a backflip? I'd say backflip. And Elijah crawling to the corner now. Nope. Now I need him back. While I have everyone's attention for 1 minute, let me know in the chat or the comments. I'm not sure if I'm premiering this video or not. This is a little bit of a recorded audio, but let me know if there's any advice, any comments for the show ahead of this new season. I thank everyone for sticking by. But back to the action at hand. I won't get all sappy right now. Elijah with a clothesline. Oh, now picking him up, going for some kind of fireman's carry. Oh, an airplane spin. Classic tech. Oh, no, TKO. Able to go for the cover? No, he's not. Okay. Odd choice on the part of Elijah there. Oh, now going for the playmaker. That overdrive. Oh, wait, Marcus kicked right back up. Oh, kick to the knee. Nope. Going for another airplane spin? Interesting technique on the part of Elijah, but I guess it works. Elijah picking him up now. Maybe setting up for that. Oh, no, wait, went for a super kick. I thought maybe he was going for that Michinoku driver, but I guess not. Oops. Oh, okay. I don't even know what to call it, but it was definitely a DDT of some sort. Oh, kick to the... Oh, knocking Marcus down with a single kick. Oh, pushing him out of the way now. Went for some kind of cutter there, it looked like, but got caught. Oh, and now... Kind of like a knee breaker? I'm not... Maybe like a code breaker style move, but... Anyway, now... Oh, tripping Marcus up. Now going for that submission hold. I can't see exactly what's happening in the front of the submission, but looks like Marcus is struggling a little bit. No, he is not. He got out of knees to the back of the head and straight punches. Oh, no, soul kick. Oh, now Dragon with Elijah's very aggressive right now. This is a much-needed side here. He's definitely taking Marcus to the limit already, and it's only been, it's 4 minutes into the match already. Oh, no, oh, not a dive. I would have loved a dive. Oh, wait. 619? Interesting. Jumping back in the ring now. Oh, Marcus went for a kick there. Got caught. Irish whip. Oh, going for that snapmare, maybe? Oh, nope. Taking him into the corner. Go for that Aztec press style maneuver. That moonsault off the top rope there. No cover, though. Interesting choices. I don't think either man has gone for a cover yet. I mean, I would be surprised if the first cover on the match ends up being the pinfall that wins the match. That'd be great. That'd be a... Oh, huh, okay. Well, Marcus fell, apparently. He tripped over Elijah's head. Doesn't happen often, but, hey, if you... Oh, wait, he's back up already. I'll have to check the replays, but I think he tripped over Elijah's head. Kind of weird, but okay. And now Marcus went for a lawn dart there. Oh, Marcus feeling the effects of it. And Elijah just spun around 360 degrees. Almost looked like me at 180. Oh, 2K, we love you. Oh, went for... Oh, a faint DDT caught him. Going for the cover, maybe. Nope. He's not a lot of pinfalls being made here. Odd choice on the part of both these men. Oh, went for... drop kick to the back there. Neither men have hit their signature or finishing maneuver, I believe. Oh, wait. Maybe I spoke too soon. No, no, just a simple powerbomb. Okay, I did not speak too soon. And now Marcus stomping on the hand. Now slamming Elijah into the mat there. Oh, another spinning soul kick. Oh, went for another one but got caught. Elijah going for a swinging neck breaker there. Oh, wait. Now I'm landing on... I don't even know what to call that. It's like sprung up on his hands to hit some kind of like a... Well, I guess a moonsault. We're just going to call everything a moonsault here. Anytime you flip, it's a moonsault. Sorry, I had to laugh on my own joke. Anyway, Marcus going for a kick there. But Elijah went for a running knee there but missed. And now Marcus took him down with a clothesline. I think every move from now on will be called the moonsault, just no matter what it is. Okay. Elijah now going for... If it's another airplane spin, son of a bitch. Someone needs to get Marcus a doggy bag, because I don't think I can handle another one of those spins. Oh, wait, call for the crowd to get... Give him a little bit of a comeback here. Maybe we can toss him into the corner. And he does, slams him into the corner. Oh, now going for a little bit of a wave of momentum here on Elijah's part. Backflip moonsault off the turnbuckle. Oh, running clothesline. Everything's a moonsault. Now Elijah throwing him to the outside. Interesting choice. Can't pin him on the outside. While we're here on the outside. Oh, that was a beautiful counter there. Oh, another good reverse. Okay, hold on. Lots of reverses here. Okay, anyway. Every match here now at the Valiant Wrestling Alliance will be under a 20 count limit, just so we know this for future reference. DQs, everything normal, except 20 counts, so we can avoid a count out situation, because let's face it, count out victories suck. But anyway, in the ring right now, Marcus in that arm trapped crossface, getting out of it one more time. Excuse me. Oh, running knee there, caught him. He's gonna go for the cover. Finally, the first cover of the match. One, two. Oh, just a two count. Not enough to keep Marcus down quite yet. I think Elijah may have. Oh, and now calling for the finishing maneuver right here. This might be it right now. Oh, and a counter, a kick to the back of the knee. Oh, now Elijah ducking, throwing him over. I'm surprised he didn't go for an airplane spin. I thought he was gonna. That code breaker style move there. Now leg drop. Chaining his inner Hulkamania there. Oh, kick. Go for another face breaker. I don't even know what to call it. Is code breaker licensed? I don't know. It's a face breaker now. Drop kick to the knee. Now. Going up to the top rope. Elijah Riley, not a top rope kind of guy. Just an elbow drop. Okay. Interesting. He's not. Okay. Maybe going for another one. Hey. Okay. Crowd loving it, apparently. They are loving Elijah Riley right now. Oh, now kick to the stomach. Oh, and a bicycle. Oh, maybe like a pump kick, bicycle knee strike. Oh, no, calling for a speech in music. I believe there's a name for this finisher. I apologize that I don't have it on hand. I'll remember this for next time. Very unprofessional of me, but going for the cover. One, two, three, and we have a new television champion. Congratulations, Marcus Williams, on a successful debut, winning the television championship. Marcus Williams making a hell of a debut, but he has to look forward to next week when he has to defend that title that he just won. He has to defend it weekly, so we'll see if he can handle that as we spy on the crowd from behind these bleachers. But as we move forward into our next match, I believe it'll be the Tag Team Championship match. And welcome back. For some reason, we went from Philadelphia to Wheeling, West Virginia. And we are introducing on the way to the ring. I'm not very good at pronouncing Japanese names, so I will just say that this is hashtag YOLO. I don't know if the hashtag is included, but the team is YOLO. I feel weird saying that because that's just weird. But I'm not familiar on their names. I'll have to study my Japanese pronunciation so I don't come off as... I believe it's Gakudo and Ryusei, maybe? I'm not familiar with the names exactly. Forgive me. making their way to the ring. Should be accompanied by Scott Osborne, not an in-ring competitor as much anymore, but still does hold that briefcase. The Prestige, the tag team champions. Philip Sheffield on the right, Matt Bailey on the left. Those newly minted tag team championships, which may be in due for a redesign soon, we will see, but this is their first title defense since the little mini show, and before that, I don't remember the last time they defended this. They have been champions for approximately 100 days now. Not a lot of competition in terms of tag teams they've had to face so far, but as they make their way to the ring, hoping for a successful title defense. Now, old teams in the ring, those tag titles with a black square on it, you know, that's how they come. Oh, okay. And as on this corner, we have YOLO, the Ryusei and Kokoto, I guess that's how you pronounce it, versus the Prestige, Matt Bailey and Philip Sheffield. Very excited. And now, we're going to take those tag team championships. I mean, what if we crown brand new tag team champions tonight? But you gotta remember that Scott Osborne is in the corner of Prestige, which is a reason to be worried. No, I believe that's the Kokoto. I don't know how to say it properly, but the blue one. Starting off the match against Matt Bailey already. The onslaught starting already. Going straight after Matt Bailey there. Picking him up now. Going for... Oh, wait. Grabbed him by the hair and yanked him back. Now, you gotta remember, this is the YOLO, or kind of a brand new team to professional wrestling. Matt Bailey and Philip Sheffield have been here for a while now. For a couple months. Maybe like a year or so now. They've been a formidable team. So, I mean... It's about experience here too. Prestige have hanged on to those championships for a while now. I don't think they're gonna want to let them go anytime soon, but attacking that knee there, it's not looking good for Kudo's knee there. Oh, went for a knee drop. It was nowhere close. Maybe going for a headbutt instead. Oh, getting a little bit of shake, rattle, and roll there, and a knee to the sternum there. Oh, went. Oh, now go for a reverse DDT, it looks like. Now, this is a 18 minutes left on the clock. What is the idea? I mean, what if YOLO can't put down Prestige in the time limit? That's always something to look at. I mean, this is their one opportunity for the championships. I mean, if they can't win them here tonight, that puts them right at the back of the line in terms of title opportunities. So hopefully they can do it. I mean, he's definitely laying the smackdown on Matt Bailey now. Matt's already crawling to Phillip, but he can't get to him. Just Kudo laying in those strikes there. And now flexing that that small frame. Went for a cutter there. Got caught. Oh, went for another one, but got caught again. Irish whip now. Oh, not belly going for something. Oh, like a backbreaker style submission. Oh, and he got out of it. Now elbows. Oh, caught his leg there. Now just an elbow to the knee. Ooh. Now the strikes come. Oh, Hurricanrana now taking down Matt. And now he finally got that cutter. I'm not going to go for a cover, though, off of that. Oh, and now... Oh, he punched him, and Matt Billy did not seem phased at all. Now taking him to the corner there. Slamming his face off that turnbuckle pad. I went for something, but... Oh, he was pushing him away. Oh, Enziguri caught him. I think the tip of his foot nearly missed. Oh, now Matt with the clothesline. You gotta remember Matt in that vicious ripcord clothesline that he uses so well, that ripcord lariat. Usually preluded by a German suplex, but we'll see. Gotta be remember, Prestige can whip out a submission like it's nothing. I mean, I'd be careful if I was ill. I wouldn't underestimate Prestige. They are a working unit. Now Phillip Sheffield in the ring. In a kitchen sink, just taking him down. He didn't even get back up. That just took him straight down. Now Phillip going for that suplex, just throwing him. Oh, and a kip up. Oh, and now dropkick taking him right back down. Now he's trying to crawl to his brother, I believe. Ryusei? I'm not familiar on this one's pronunciation. But we'll go with the red one for now until I can figure out how to properly say it. I went for a strike there, but Phillip running back in the ring only to get punched again. I don't think that worked out well in his favor. Now kick to the stomach. Matt Bailey back on the apron. The Kakuto brothers still on the outside, and oh, going for a dive here. That Tope, the hero, I think is the proper term for it. And now taking some time to taunt. Not a good idea. They gotta get him back in the ring if they want to get a cover or something. They can't just spend all their time out here. They add to the count of 20, though, so they do have time to inflict as much damage as they really can. And now, now Phil throwing him back. Oh, nope. Phillip came back in the ring. Scott Osborne climbing in the ring for some reason. Don't know what he was doing there. Oh, now the other brother interfering. Where's Matt Bailey when you need him? Oh, now just throwing me into his brother's shins there. Throwing Phillip Sheffield back in the ring. Now crawling over to Matt Bailey. Tag. Oh, just stared at him. Oh, not going for those strikes to the knee. Going for a pinfall under that. Will the pain be too much for him to bear? One, two. And now a kick out. But you gotta remember, those knees are not gonna... I mean, after the procedure, very masterful at picking apart limbs there, so they better watch themselves unless they're gonna be having to wear a knee brace for the next couple of weeks if they're not careful. Now just choking them off the ropes there. A little bit of a dirty tactic, but I guess the job done. Excuse me, I'll take a sip of water. Excuse me. And now Matt Bailey was taking a breather, laying on the rope there. That was kind of neat looking, but oh, now punch to the stomach, keeping him at bay. Oh, now Phillip back on the apron with that running shin strike, taking down the Ruse brother. Oh, now DDT taking him down again. Now kick to the face, taking the mat. Now, you remember right now, there's not a lot of teams here currently in the virus. We have these two teams and I believe one other. Which can say as of right now. But if Yolo isn't able to win, they may just have to wait and sit at the back of the line for other teams to come through. And picking him up. Oh, now going for kicks to the leg, and now a bicycle knee strike. It is just a slugfest in the ring here between Matt and... here it is, that ripcord lariat. Going for the cover. That clothesline. One, two... Oh, and I think it would have been over right there, but if we would have got in there just in the nick of time to save him. Now it's running over there. Excuse me, Happy Joe. Now grinding his fist against the head. Those knees are not at 100%. That left knee, I believe. Matt leaving the ring. Oh, taking a breather, it looks like. Trying to collect some wind there. Oh. Uze's yelling at him. And he's back on the outside now. Go for that second ride style kind of maneuver. Picking him up. Throwing back in the ring over the cover. No, throwing towards the steps. Now both the Yolo brothers just staring at Matt Bailey. And creepily, I might add. They're just staring a hole through him. He can pick him up and get him in the ring. I don't know what they're doing there. Outside to break the referee's kick. Smart. And that spin soul kick that got caught. Kick to the knee. And another shoe strike. Those knees are not going to be at 100%. That is for sure. We'll have to see if we have a positive knee brace. And that tension with the crowd. Now more kicks to the knee. That left knee is just getting picked apart now. Go for cover off underneath those strikes. Oh no, kicked out at the nick of time there. Oh no, going for it. Oh, and hold on, okay. A slight error in judgment on Bobby Russo. He got caught and he hit Phillip instead of Matt, who was the intended target. Took the hit and was on the outside and not tripping on that ball. Right, knee to his stomach now. Backbreaker style submission. Flanking in the arms now. Double-legs in the back. And now just stomping the knee there. There is no way that his knee is at 100%. Absolutely no way. Timing out now. Kudo back in there. Matt Bailey still taking the fight. Matt Bailey is help his kind of personality though. He is very much the lone fighter. He will go in there, he will fight for however long he needs to. He does not like to tag, even not very often. He didn't take him down but a drop kick. Drag, taking him down. Oh, now stomped to the head. I don't know how he got going down all of a sudden, but now, oh no, he's gonna bend that knee. Oh god, he's wearing an armor pad. Oh, that shoulder picked apart now. Matt Bailey, for sure, is picking apart the limbs of these two young men. They're taking down that character. I was gonna move. First DDT taking it down. Going for something, but I caught with clothesline. Oh no, he's gonna stomp. Oh, he just stomped that one inwards. That is not the way that you're supposed to bend. We're going to have to see if we can have something better than an elbow by you in the elbow race. He's not fighting back. Oh no, the ref got taken down. Oh, ref back up though. He was not taken down too long. flame. Why did you throw him outside? Back in. Not a very smart move. He just takes a kind of time. These two young men, not very, they're having too much fun with it. They need to get serious and get some maneuvers in and really try and finish this match. They're taunting to the crowd way too much. Another flip there, landing on Matt Slater. Now going for the top opening. As it got a snow for him. Shooting star press, but missed. Little knees were way too stubborn. Went for a punch, but caught. And now butterfly suplex from Matt Slater. Security there. 2.5 minutes remaining. Go for a pinfall. 1, 2. Just a 2 count. Or 3. You can see the very tear is going to affect him. Fist buster there. 1, 2. And oh my god. That would have been 3 right there, I think. Philip Sheffield ducking Roberto and trying to close him in there to break up the pinfall. And he's going for a Corona driver. I need to start doing something. 1.5 minutes remains. Clock is running down. The timer runs out for Steve McTains. I'm going to go for another Corona driver. I'm going to get a pinfall in here. Corner. And that was like some of the kick combo, like just taking apart the knees there in the corner. And now going for a running knee attack here. And smashing him in the face now. Less than a minute remains. If this gets down to about the 15-second timer, there's no way either of these guys going to pinfall here. Dragon Super is taking it down. Right there, Rumble hyping himself up a little bit. And tripping him up. And you say no, just going for a surfboard curb stomp. Slam his face into the ground. 30 seconds remain. Someone needs to do something quick. Oh, went for a super kick. They got caught. Oh, knee strike. Oh, we're in the corner now. Oh, kick to face. They're going for a snap there now. 15 seconds. I don't. There's no way. It's. No, 10 seconds remain. There's no way. The Prestige have retained the championships. Ladies and gentlemen, we are now on to our third match of the evening, our United States Championship match, making his way out of the former champion, Eli Drago, Mr. Five Stars himself, losing that championship on the last little mini show to Ace Reeves, who is the second all-time champion. These two have been feuding for that championship for quite a while now, actually. Eli looking to finally gain back what he thinks is rightfully his, and we'll see if he's able to do that here tonight. Now you see the crowd sign, the most must-see superstar. That is definitely a good way to describe Mr. Five Stars himself. One to always steal a show, but somebody who's stole something recently from him. Ace Reeves, our United States champion. That newly minted United States championship around his waist there. Ace Reeves, the first ever two-time United States champion and the second overall United States champion. Only three people have actually held that championship, so very prestigious. I mean, these two men going back and forth for that championship in the last couple months. Ace Reeves, though, dealing with some injuries that we will have to discuss later in the match there, but as he makes his way into the ring, hoping to successfully defend his United States championship. That is what it's for, baby. The United States Championship. One of the most sought after championship in this company right now. A3's handing off that championship. And will Eli reclaim what he thinks is rightfully his? We'll see. Rev holding it up. Eli in the corner, staring a hole through Ace. And now ref over the bell. Starting off already, going for that grapple there. Oh, I'm dragging him down. Now, as I said earlier, Ace is dealing with a sort of a back injury. He has been taking some time off of wrestling, but he has committed to defending the United States Championship. He has stated he's been cleared to compete, though. I don't know if his back can handle too much damage, though. Eli Drago, though, definitely committed. I know he wants that United States Championship back. He is the pure embodiment of Valiant Wrestling Alliance, very loyal member of our roster. I know he wants to represent us as the U.S. Champion. Now, oh, clothesline. Like I said earlier, look at that. Ace Reeves landing on his back, grabbing at his pec region. Eli taking a lot of time to taunt. That is never a good idea here in this company. Taunting can get you can draw, you can lose. It's not very good. But now on the outside, remember, every match has a 20 count limit. So these men could stay out here until the count of 19 if they want. And now that I think about it, the same way with Prestige, if there's a draw, Ace retains the championship, count out DQ. And I'm not sure what happened there. Looked like Eli went for a knee, but Ace duck maybe? Oh, now elbows. They are getting extremely close to that steel grating. Oh, no. Ace has got to watch out. He's getting extremely close. We don't want him landing on that back there. Oh, now landing on that mat on the outside. Eli just stomping his arm. Oh, went for a kick there. Got caught tossing him. This is not looking good. They need to get in the ring. I'm not sure what the referee's count is at, but look for a kick there. Nope, ducking. No, no. DDT dropping him. Oh, no. Uh-oh. And like I said earlier, landing on that steel. Oh, he had enough energy to kick right back up. But I don't know if he's going to be at 100% after landing on his back on that steel grating. Ace Reeves back in the ring. Taking some time to taunt. Eli's got to get in there. And he made it. Oh, and now taking him, maybe going to take him to the rope, go for that five-star cutter. And he is, I believe, getting ready for it. Off the ropes and a cutter. Gonna go for the cover now, maybe. This could be it already. One. Just a one count. Ace not gonna give up so easy. I'm not going for a. Oh! A Canadian pile driver. Back on the outside now. This is a dangerous area. Obviously, we have had some major improvements to our arena here in this not Wheeling, West Virginia. This Philly stadium, if you cannot disclose the name of it. That new barricade and all these new things at ringside. Taking advantage of it, slamming into that steel barricade. Now Eli just staring a hole through him. Oh, now going for a rolling cutter maybe? And he does that sliced bread kind of maneuver. Eli has taken the fight to Ace. He is trying to injure him. Oh, punch to the stomach now. On that back fist. Oh, and now a chop of his own. Now he's chucking Ace Reeves. Eli back in the ring now. Just waiting for Ace Reeves now. Oh, wait, nope. Going back outside. Went for a flying knee there, but ducked. Oh, and now one. Oh, a kick now. Kick to the stomach. Oh, and basement dropkick taking down Ace. Ace is back up, heading for the ring now. Eli following him shortly behind. Excuse me, I had to go. Eli now going to the top rope. Is he going to go for that double moonsault that he does? Ace is still rolling. And he connects with that double rotation moonsault. Go for the cover. One, two, three. No. Okay. Well, just a two count. Those damaged ribs of Ace Reeves obviously not keeping him down enough. He's still fighting. Oh, now insult to injury here. Just smashing down on those ribs. Oh no, is he going for that double rotation moonsault again? He is now going to go for a cover off of it. One, two, three. Oh, Ace Reeves kicking out again? Those ribs have got to be killing Ace right now. Two double rotation moonsaults already. Oh, now Ace fighting back a little bit here. Throwing into the ropes now. Oh, tossing him up and that spinning kick. I don't even know what to say right now. One, two, oh, and Eli kicking out just in the nick of time there. Ace can't believe it. That he catched him mid-air with that Trouble in Paradise kind of style move. Oh, now Ace calling for him to get up. Get a little bit of a wave of momentum here. Went for a strike, but got caught. Oh, Eli kicked to the back of the knee there. Ace Reeves taking him to the corner now. And the snapmare taking him down. Draw kick to the back of the neck. Ace duck. Oh, duck. Clothesline. Eli taking him down. This could be Eli's chance to take advantage here. Oh, now going to stomp his face into the mat there. Went for a kick, but oh, got caught with another one. Ace Reeves falling down immediately. Eli yelling at the crowd here. Oh, now going for a running knee attack. He clips him. Ace is hurting right now. Oh, now Eli just stomping on him. Oh, now Eli climbing the top rope. Can this be the final nail in the coffin for Ace Reeves? I hope not. Go for double rotation moonsault and it connects. Third time's the charm. Going for the cover. One, two, and three. And Eli Drago has picked up the victory and gotten his United States Championship back. Mr. Five Stars is now the United States Champion again. The second person to hold that title twice. We'll have to see now if he's leaving. He's mentally cleared to even come back and fight for that. We'll have to see. We'll let you all know. But as we move forward into our number one contenders, Fatal 4-Way. opportunities now. If there's a draw, it's a real problem. One of these men will get to the end of it. He's still in the game. He's still figuring out those kind of fun. We'll look at this. For this one, I had to combine entrances from different clips because 2K kept crashing on me. But now, introducing the next two competitors. This is the former main event status. This is the new and improved Marvelous one, Matt Brooks. Matt Brooks waits, as so does Bashan and Alex Wright, even though they're not at ringside. Justice Stone making his way to the ring. A former tag team champion here in Valorous and Lights Not has had a war with Scott Osborne when he was the world champion, but hasn't had a really good chance yet. Good footing, but this could be the chance he needs. So he makes his way to the ring. One of these men have an opportunity, and we'll see who makes the most of it here tonight. Now all four men in the ring. It's going to be a little bit tough to call, but I'm going to do my best here. There's going to be a little lot of action I need to focus on here. But, and so it seems like Justice Stone, Matt Brooks going at it. Alexander Bashan and Alex Wright going at it. And now Matt Brooks taking Justice Stone to the outside. And now a little bit of a grapple contest on the outside there. Oh, it's spearing him into the apron and back in the ring. Discus clothesline taking down Alex Wright. Now, Alex Wright did just have that match against Johnny Respawn. That Johnny Respawn, unfortunately, suffered that knee injury, which was what kicked him out of the world title match later. But that opponent that he handpicked, I'm not familiar with who it is yet. I mean, they haven't entered the building quite yet. But Wyatt Evans definitely preparing backstage for anybody. But one of these men could be their big shot. But now Matt Brooks clothesline to the back of the head of Justice in the ring. Alex Wright going for something, but Michelle throwing him back. Matt Brooks just stomping Justice on the outside. Oh, kick to the face now. Oh, go for a clothesline. And now in the ring, Alex Wright fighting off Sean. Now Justice and Matt Brooks back in the ring now, and I have no idea what that was, but somehow he's in a crossface now. That was a little odd style move by Alex Wright there. And now he's gonna snap that shoulder. Oh no. And stomping on that bandaged arm, that tape that he wears on that shoulder, that forearm. And now pile driver. Maybe gonna go for a cover off of that. No. One, two, no, kicking out. Oh, now hitting that sky high. Alexander Sean going for the cover. This could be it. That was his finishing maneuver. One, two, and kick out after that. Oh, a pop-up cutter from Alex Wright. Now he's going to go for the pinfall. I believe that's his signature maneuver there. No, picking him up. Okay. Oh, Matt taunting to Vachon. Not a good idea. And now, like that, a suplex like that. He should have been more careful. Sean went for something, but got a clothesline for his trouble there. And now a sit-out suplex, dropping him down. That was just Alex Wright and Alexander Vachon in the ring right now. Now carrying to the corner. Oh, and now those elbows to the face now. Went for something. There's a lot. Everyone's just going for whoever they can grab here, it seems. Now Justice throwing some stomps out there on the outside. A power slam on the inside. Does the Sean go for cover? No. Now Justice going straight after Matt Brooks. All these men only 3 minutes in, but they are all power hitters. They are all going for each other as much as they can. And a spine buster there. Oh, Sean now calling for him to get up here. Oh, now Justice Stone interrupting him, going for those kicks now. Oh, now he's calling for that finishing maneuver, that BFT. Blunt force trauma clothesline. He took him down. He's gonna go for the cover now. Vachon and Alex need to focus on what's happening in the ring. One, two, three, and Vachon and Alex were not quick enough to get in there. Justice advances to pay-per-view. Congratulations, Justice Stone. He'll advance to face whoever wins the world championship match here next. Stick around. We have a message for you all. So real quick, I have about 30 seconds, so I'm just going to make this as quick as I can. I want to thank everyone for sticking by while I've been on a little bit of a break. I'm going to try to be getting back into the weekly stuff. I've been putting off this episode because I was sick, as some of the people in the Twitter locker room, I guess you can say, know. But I truly do want to thank everyone for sticking by. This has really helped me get out of my social anxiety bubble. But enough of the sappy shit. I know what you want to see. World Heavyweight Championship match. Next, Wyatt, surprise competitor. I'll see you all there. fucking Philly. We are. Call us WrestleMania 2 because we are in fucking 5 different cities for this show. Yeah, it's Virginia, Brian Evans now with the opportunity of a lifetime. He was originally picked to be Johnny Rusev in the Cohen for this debut episode, but unfortunately, Johnny Rusev came down with a knee injury from that match with Alex Wright, so he had to pick somebody to replace him. And, I don't know who to pick. We're going to see him out. He has arrived at the building. He can fill it. He's ready. But I don't know who it is yet. But we'll see. Wyatt has no time to get prepared for Johnny Respawn. Not really this mystery opponent, so we'll see. Whoever it is, Wyatt Evans will not take lightly. He wants the World Heavyweight Championship. He's won it since day one. Time to finally see who this mystery opponent is. And oh, I know that music anywhere. Is it who I think it is? Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Respawn has picked the dangerous Benny Banks has been the replacement for Johnny Respawn. He was the former, he was the European champion. But that championship since went defunct. I guess that's why he was allowed to compete here, as a way to make up for that European championship being just removed from standing. But Johnny Respawn has selected Benny Banks to be his replacement. This is a shocker for me. Wow. I don't know what to say right now. Championship, which will maybe be in a redesign until we find a good design that we like currently. That is the design we're at, the World Championship. We're holding it up. Wyatt Evans had no time to prepare for Benny Banks. And he is here. Oh no, 20 minutes on the clock. This is the first fall wins. Wyatt was not prepared for this. I wasn't prepared for this. Already, Benny taking him down. Oh wait, no, Wyatt flipping him around. Wyatt proving he's a great wrestling, a mat wrestler. Oh no, taking him to the back there, throwing us the ropes now. Went for, oh, it's the dragon suplex. Not gonna go for the cover though. Not enough quite yet. Oh no, Wyatt just slapping Benny. I don't think that he appreciates who Johnny Respawn selected there, but not Benny with those kicks to the knee. And no shoulder tackle, but neither one fell. Now, locking up again. Twisting that arm now. Taking behind that back, that hammerlock. Now just wrenching on the arm. Oh, now going for that overhead belly-to-belly suplex. Wyatt is really taking the fight to Benny right now. Oh, and just as I say that, Benny now going with a wave of momentum. Uppercut to the back of the head. Oh, Wyatt's arm got clipped on that rope there. Looked like it hurt a little bit there. Oh, now attacking the knee. Oh, now a chop now. Oh, dropkick taking him down. And now just wrenching on that right arm there. Benny Banks picking him up now. Yeah, we haven't seen Benny Banks in quite a while. Ever since a pay-per-view a couple months back where he became the European champion, but that title did not come with into the new season. It's since been retired. Oh, wait. Two? Oh, just not a three count yet. But yeah, that European championship did not come with him into the new season, so I guess this is a... I guess management allowed this as a way to repay him for, I guess, taking away the championship he never lost. Blocking that kick. I don't think the crowd is very much into this contest. I don't think the crowd likes either of these men. That one man is very, very adamant about how he feels. Oh, and now that woman is. They are not enjoying this match. Yikes. Wrenching on the neck there, though. Now those shots, the stomach. Oh, whoa, he went for a hurricanrana sometime, but not a powerbomb. Oh, went for an enziguri, but fell. Okay. Interesting choice. No. Betty's throwing him into the corner now. Take him to the top. Oh, no, this is not going to end well. This never ends well for both men. Is he going to go for a hurricanrana? Oh, and a hurricanrana off the top. No hands, throwing him. Go for the cover, Benny. This could be it. No, he's not going to go for the cover. He's picking him back up. Oh, now going for that. Oh, that Oklahoma slam. And now it's an uppercut. This match has flipped in the favor of Benny Banks. He is now just taking the fight to Wyatt Evans. That back is probably feeling the pain right now. Oh, now calling for him to get up. But no. He's on his hands. Oh, and he just kicked the arm the opposite. That is not the way the arm is supposed to bend. But Wyatt Evans, I think he just ignored the pain. Said one for a clubbing blow to the back. Ref didn't even get a one count there. Crowd seems to be favorably behind Wyatt Evans here. Oh, and now soul kick taking him into the ropes there. Drop kick. And another one. Ducking it. Going for a swinging neck breaker. Wyatt with a bit of momentum. Could he hit a finishing maneuver here and end it? Going for a power bomb. Oh, going for the cover. Now this could be it. One. Two. Just a two count. Benny kicking out at two. Benny does not want to give up this opportunity. Oh, now calling for him to get up. Is he going to go for that X-plex? No, he's not going to go for it. He's going for a dragon sleeper. But Benny instantly getting out of it. He scouted that maneuver. Oh, now Benny taking him to the ropes. Is he going to go for a dive here? Oh, I think he is. The crowd on their feet. Those three guys near Wyatt Evans behind the barricade just chilling for some reason. Oh, 2K. We love you. Now, Benny, suicide dive. Slamming Wyatt's back into that barricade. Picking him up now. He's going to throw him back in the ring, I hope. And he does. Going to go for the cover, maybe. That could be all she wrote. That could be out. No. Benny calling for a finisher. He's going to put the nail in the coffin, literally, and just end this with a solid... Oh, a spear bomb style powerbomb. That last ride style powerbomb. Go for the cover. This be it. One, two, and three. And Benny Banks has won the world championship. We finally have a champion again. Johnny Respawn's pick. He did it. He is now a world champion. Wyatt Evans is definitely going to be furious about this. I mean, we'll have to see if maybe there'll be a rematch, but Justice Stone looks to be the front runner towards that championship. Thank you all for joining me on this episode, and we'll see you hopefully next week or week after. Still figuring out the schedule. But have a good night, everyone.